Hello, Swapin.
Hi, Raj.
So what we discussed in the last class?
Rest.
Yeah, REST web services, right? And we have seen some of the annotations like get the rate path and get the rate git. And we have to see about the post, all those things. And yesterday we have seen the resources represented in plain text format, right?
Yeah.
We have seen how to represent the results in plain text and how to access that method. How to access that method. So when you call this get method, it's going to return the output of your application. That is this output. Okay, since we are representing plain text and there is only one method, it comes to this method automatically. So today let us see the other representations. Here. We are having at the rate get, at the rate produces. Media type text HTML means we can send the we can represent the resource in HTML format. Text HTML. We can write the method here, public string say HTML hello. Say HTML. Here we can include the HTML code. How to include this? Just to insert it, and the HTML should go in double quotes. The HTML should go in what? Double quotes. Right? So, if you want to represent the resource in XML format, again you can say at the rate get. Again, at the rate produces media type dot application underscore XML. Application underscore. Excellent. Then I can go with the method here, public string, say XML hello. So in this one, we can return, again should go in double quotes. XML version equal to slash double quotes, 1.0 slash double quotes. We are using some tags for that. Now, how to invoke these methods here? So we are representing the resource in different formats like text plain, text HTML and application XML. Then how to invoke the different representations in the client program. Okay, so for that we have to add some more code in your client program. So in this one, let me keep all these things in comments. Now we have connected to this URL, that is we are referring to the hello. We are referring to this hello here. Means you are referring to this resource, hello class here. And in this hello class, we are having the methods where they are representing in different forms. Then how to invoke these methods? How to invoke these methods is, so here we can include the code. You can say, sysout w.accept. We have to call the method here w.accept. And here we have to mention the representation type. In which representation you want to call it? Let's consider media type dot text plain. So when you say media type dot text plain, dot get, and if you say get string dot class, because the return type is of type string here, string dot class, then it will invoke your method which is producing text plain. So this method will get invoked here, the output. When you run this code, so we get the output. We have to start the server, that is missing. So we cannot run the client program until the server is started. So right click on press WS, run as, run on server. So yeah, we have to deploy the project in server. If the server is started only, if the server is running only, we can run the client program. Let us start once again. Once the server is started, now we can run the client. So here we are getting the result as hello Jesse. So which method it has called? Since we have mentioned the media type as text plain, so it's going to the text plain. If you want to access in other formats, then simple. Just we have to mention the representation type over here. So if you go for this text HTML, then it's going to call the resource which is representing an HTML file. Then for this, you can go for application underscore XML. Run this code. Here we are getting, see, first one is simple text plain, and second one it is representing the resource in HTML format, and the third one is XML format. Clear all of you? How to represent the resource in different formats? Right, everybody.
Right, but shouldn't it have be like HTML should be like bold or something? Because it should have.
Because we are running on the standalone. We are writing the code over there. So if you want to get it in bold, all those things, then we have to make use of browser, web application. Web application means we have to write the code using servlets or JS. Want to get this hello JSON in bold. It's a simple standalone application, main method.
Will it matter if we change text underscore HTML to text plain and return HTML body, because it looks like a string only?
Yeah, it looks like a string only, it's complete string part only. Because we are running on the standalone, not on browser. Main method applications, the standalone applications, we cannot run it on browser, right? Sugar?
Right.
So which application we can run on browser? Either HTML or servlets or JSP only, right?
Right.
So that only we are going to see next. So here the client program is standalone client here. Got it, everyone?
Okay.
The client is what here? Standalone client, simple client here. Now let us go for web client. Let us go for what? Web client here. So for that, So let us go for web query. So for that, what you can do? Create a JSP page.
But how we know that it's a standalone test?
Main method. Okay, main, if you are having main method, it means standalone, right?
Okay.
So create a JSP page. We can select web hello client dot JSP in REST WS project. You can create anywhere. Okay, I'm just creating in the same project. So if you are creating JSP page, means the client project should be compulsory web application only. The client project should be what? Web application only. Okay, remember that. Web hello client dot JSP. So let us see this code. Now here we are having three representations, right? So here we are having three representations. Let us see this code and understand more. So create a JSP page in this REST WS. I'm using the same project. You can even go for new projects also. It will work. Create a JSP page. I'm giving the name web hello client. In this one, I want to go with admit ID. So when you say it, AHREF equal to, then pass the complete URL, http://localhost:8080/REST WS/, what is the path? Hello, right? Sorry, REST, the URL pattern name, hello is the path. And when you say get, click here. Save it, run this code. So when you click here, we get only hello JSP. Means by default it is going to what? Plain text. The default representation of your methods will be what? Plain text. The resource is represented in plain text. So it's just going to hello JSP. It won't go to other methods. It won't go to other methods. So how to make it to go to other methods is, so for the method also, once you come to the resource hello, if you want to go to the respective methods, if you want to go to the respective methods, here we can go with the path there. Again, for the method also, we can say the path, @path, and here I'm giving it text. I'm simply giving text here. And for this HTML, we'll say @path HTML. For this, we'll say @path XML. So I'm giving the path for the methods also separately here. First, you are coming to the resource hello, and you can even access the respective methods. Whichever the methods you want to access, we can access again by using path. So how to call this method now, the plain text? Here in the client program, we'll say here, plain text. We'll say here, plain text. So if you want to access plain text, what I need to do? You have to say here, /text. First, you are going to the resource. From there, you are going to the respective method. Similar way, you can go for other things also. If you want to access HTML, then here we say HTML. If you want to go with XML, here we say XML. Got it, everyone? This code?
Yeah.
Right, everyone?
Yeah.
Run this. Okay, so if I click on this plain text, we get only plain text. If you click on this HTML, now you got it here, Shiva? Your
yeah.
board? Right?
Yeah.
If you say XML, we get the XML code. XML is not coming properly. Let us do one thing. Change the browser window. Sometimes it won't work properly in browser. The perspective has been changed. So I'm choosing the browser as Chrome. Now run this. So plain text, HTML, and XML. We get the XML. Some problem with this.
Raj, is it is XML case sensitive too?
Yes, yes.
Well, closing and opening, one you give capital and one you give small, maybe that's the reason.
Definitely.
The return statement.
Run this application. So now if you click on XML, we get the XML code. Okay, got it?
Yeah.
Okay. So maximum we use HTML or plain text formats. So depends on the client requirement, we can make the resource available. That is the advantage of paying for REST web services. Let us go for the next concept. Okay, after you are clear, everyone know? Jyoti?
Yeah.
Yeah, Hima Bindu?
Yeah.
Okay, Monica Shiva?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Soumya?
Yeah, Raj.
Right? Srijana Swati?
Yeah.
Right? Vinila?
Yeah.
Right? Something complex but web services is not that much easy. So we have to explore one second. We have to go through all these things one second. Then. Now let us go for the next part today. That is, I want to read HTML form data into a web service. So the user will enter the data in HTML form. How to read that form data into a web service? So let us see. So reading HTML form data into a service means your resource. Here in the case, the web service is called as a resource. So for this one, we use an annotation called as @formparam. @formparam annotation is used to read form data into a service. Okay, so for this, let us understand with an application. So let us accept some details from the user, like the product details. For this, you create a JSP page. You create a JSP page. Let me call it as product.jsp in web project. REST AWS project. Refer program product.jsp. So let us see. We'll accept the data in this form. Right click on REST AWS and say new JSP. Product.jsp. Even it can be an HTML file. Okay, no issues. Create a form here. Form action equal to. So we have to connect to the resource here. How to connect to the resources? http://localhost:8080/ the project name REST AWS/ the URL pattern REST, and we give the resource path as product and we go to the method path as add. The method path we give add. And see here method equal to post. So the method will get invoked based on post request. Then here accept the details like product ID, input type equal to text, name equal to ID. Product name, input type equal to text, name equal to name. Product price, input type equal to text, name equal to price, and a submit button. Value equal to add product. So when you click on this button add product, these details should go to the resource product. That is where we have given the path as product. And in that, it should invoke the method where you have given the path as add. That is this. So create a resource. Let me call it as product service. Create a web service class. Let me call it as product service. In com.ws.rest package. Product service dot job. So in rest.ws, we are having a package already which we have created yesterday. com.ws.rest. Right click on this and say new class. And I'm giving the class name as product service. Say finish. So in order to access this resource, the path we are giving it as @ bar product. So in the client program, so when you are coming to product, it will access this product service. It will come to this product service. Once it comes to this product service, here we are invoking the method based on the method called as post. So we have to use annotation @post. Then the path what we are giving to access this resource is add. So when you are mentioning the client URL add, after product add, it will come to this method. Then here we are using public string add product. The method what you are writing here is add product. This product, to this add product, this add product should read the form data. The data we should read into this add product. So how to read the data into this form is by using a annotation here @ to the method we should pass like an argument here. @ form param. When you just say @ form param id, it will read the data what you have entered in this id text field. Very simple way to read HTML form data here. So just by using the annotation @ form param, and if you just pass the ID here, it will read the data present in ID, and that value we can store it into some other variable. That's it. Clear now? Clear how to read form data into this?
Yeah.
@ form param, just pass ID, the value what you enter, it will come and store into our Java variable ID. Good.
That's
like that, we can go for other things. @ form param. Name. This name will store it into a variable name. @ form param. Price. Dot. That's it. Okay. Now the data is available in your method, that is in your service, the data is present, and once the data is in your hand, whatever you want to do with your data, it's up to us. Okay, I'm just showing how to read the form data. Once you get the data, we can process it and we can use it. So what you are doing here, just I'm returning the data back. So we say return product added successfully, some message. So you can connect to database and you can even insert also. Okay. ID equal to the value of ID, name equal to the value of name. I'm printing the value of the robotics. Price equal to the value of price. Okay. The next step is run the application product.js, which is a client program. What is so to the client, we give the URL of this product. Run this.
Actually, usually input type equal to submit value equal to we're giving like add product. It doesn't display anywhere, right? Add product.
It will display in the HTML form. It will.
Okay. And what about product ID, product name? We are giving the name equal to ID, name equal to name, name equal to price.
Right.
It doesn't display anywhere, right?
No, it won't display. It's a text field.
No, input type equal to text. Yeah, everything is fine. Why we are giving the name?
So without giving the name, how to read the form data?
Oh, to read we are giving the name.
Yeah, to read the, if you are not giving name, the form will be displayed. But to read the form data into a servlet or JSP or any service, you have to give the names. Without giving names, there is no way of reading the data. Not possible.
Okay, then the same thing with the value also, the down value equal to add product.
Add product is what? If you are not using value, it will give the value on the submit button as submit.
Okay.
So if you want to go with your own names on your submit button, we go with value.
Okay.
Okay. Give some product details. And once you say add product, we get the output as what? Product added successfully with ID is 111, name monitoring prices. Got it available? How to read? Okay. So some cases, what is going to happen here is, if I make the browser, if you are using the browser as internal web browser, means Eclipse browser, Eclipse browser I'm using. So if you fill the data, then if you say add product, if it is not displaying the output for you, so it's saying something like launching application. Okay, application download did not success. So in this case, okay, if in Eclipse internal browser, if the application is unable to run in Eclipse internal browser, change the browser. To external. Got it, everyone? So if you are unable to run, if it is unable to run, change the browser. Okay, all of you? Right? How to change the browser? Go to Window, Web Browser, and you can choose your browsers. Which are the browser? Got it, everyone?
Yeah. Yeah.
Monica Shiva?
Yeah.
Yes.
Soumya?
Yeah, Raj.
Sujana Swati Vinila?
Yeah, Raj.
Yes. So some cases it may not run in your internal Eclipse browser, so choose external browser. Okay. Right? So I browsed like anything. I got this error. I don't know why we are getting this error. So I browsed like anything. Like I wasted near to 1 week time on this. And I got a simple solution. Let me change the browser and check it. That's it. Only small. So different people have given different explanations, but nothing has worked out. Final simple solution is change the process. Okay. All right. So that's about our web services. And before we close this today's class, I'm going to give one small project to you. I'm going to give one small project to you. So that project, I'm calling it as shopping cart project. I'm calling it as what? Shopping cart project. So if you are doing this project, means you are good with your servlets in JSP. Okay? So what this shopping cart project here is? So I've shown the complete workflow here. So here we open the file login.jsp first. We create login.jsp and we say here, welcome to XYZ online shopping, your wish, where we accept username and password and login button. And we are having one more option here called as click to register. Okay. So when you click here, it will connect to register.jsp where we accept the details like name, username, password, and retail password. And we go for register. When you click on register, you should connect to register servlet. And this register servlet should connect to the backend table users table. And in users table, go with three fields, name, username, and password. Okay. The name what you enter here should go and store into the name field. The username password should go and store into the fields, username and password. Got it, everyone? I want to store even the names also.
Yeah.
Right, everyone?
Yeah.
So when you say register select, the details should go and store into users table. So this table should be existing before you develop this application. So the backend work is we have to create a users table with three fields and items table with three fields. Item table is also backend work only. And where you should add the items here. You should add the items. There. Once the register, it will give the message for us. Registered successfully, click here to login. When you click here, it will go back to the login page. Now enter your username and password. Once you enter your username and password, when you click on login, it will connect to login servlet. And what is the role of login servlet? To check for authentication, right?
Right.
So if I have entered the username as Santosh and password as ABCD, understand? If the username is Santosh and password is ABCD, for Santosh username, what is the name?
Santosh.
Santosh. We have given the name as what? Santosh here, right? If I have entered A and password as A, the name it should take as Raj. So if I have entered Santosh and ABCD, the name it has to take Santosh. So once it is authenticated, the login servlet should connect to order item servlet and should display the name over here. So how it will pick up the name?
The database.
From the database. So what you should do is in login servlet only, understand, in login servlet only, pick up the name for that username. In login servlet only, pick up the name of username and make that name as session tracking field so that I can pass that name to the next pages. Session tracking, proper session tracking need to be done. Can I open this order item servlet directly? The URL of order item servlet? No. I should check whether you are authenticated properly or not. If you are authenticated only, I should open order item servlet. So how does tracking need to be done? By using the name field. Okay, you can make use of name field to track the session. So in login servlet, get the name of the user. Once you get the name of the user from database table, make that name as session tracking field. Like this. HTTP session session equal to request.get session and session.set attribute name comma name. Got it, everyone? How to go for session tracking?
Yeah.
Right? Then send, once you begin the session in login servlet, once you connect to order item servlet, check whether you are coming properly from previous page by using HTTP session. Get that attribute. Once you get the attribute, take that name and display over here. And a simple link log out. And this order item servlet, what it should do? It should connect to the items table and display the data over here in tabular format. So in tabular format, we are having the headings like select item, name, price, and quantity. In select item, we go with checkboxes. In select item, we go with checkboxes. And the internal value of checkbox is your item number. Okay. The logic what we are applying, the value under the checkboxes is your the item number what you have given in table. And we display the remaining item name and price. And in quantity, I'm going with the text field internally. In quantity, I'm creating text fields where the user can manually enter the quantity required. Got it, everyone? Right?
Yeah.
Then You have to pick the data from items table. Order item select should connect to items table and should pick up the data and display the data in Tableau. And once you click on place order, again you should connect to your servlet, place order servlet. Again should display the name. It has to connect to place order, means I cannot open place order servlet directly. I have to come from order item servlet, okay? For proper tracking. Then, which if I am selecting the three items, that items need to be displayed over here. The items what you have ordered. That's it. Only this is the scope. And when you click on logout, it should connect to logout servlet. And the code inside that is session.invalidate. So what is the session attribute we have created? We have to invalidate. Okay, so that session will get totally expired. Right? So try to do this one. Take 1 week to 10 days time to do this. And unable to do, just to keep email, I'll send this complete code for you. Right, everyone?
Yeah.
And the validation need to be done with the jQuery. You have to do validations with what? jQuery means what? Username should not be empty. Password should not be empty. Name should not be empty. Like that. Password and read password should match. Those all validations try to do. Okay? Right? So I'll be sending this file to you as a separate email, shopping cart project, and I'll add this workflow. So try to work on this project. So pull out some time and try to read, then you'll be totally clear with servlets and GSP concepts. Right, everyone? So that's about for today's part. And from tomorrow, I'm going to start off with one more new topic and very, very important one. We are going to enter into Java frameworks. And I'll be starting up with Hibernate tomorrow, which will go for 5 to 6 days for us. Okay? And before I close, coming to Jyoti. Can I make you presenter, Jyoti?
Yes. If
Jyoti is having some issue. If you want, you can be online. I'm making the presenter. Jyoti.
Yeah.
Can show your screen.
Are you able to see my screen?
Yeah, still no.
No?
Yeah, I got it. No? You are getting this error, right?
Yeah.
Well, creating the client program?
Yeah.
So just to click OK. So are you able to generate the Visual file?
Sometimes it's generating, sometimes it's not.
Yeah, just cancel this. Cancel.
This one?
Cancel. This complete window, cancel.
Okay.
Cancel. So can you show me the Visual file?
WebXML file?
Not WebXML, Visual.
Visual file.
Yeah, run this. Have you started this server? No, okay. So open this one, like open browser. Open browser.
Yeah, this. I've already opened it.
Yeah. So the visual file is generated, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So copy this URL.
Yeah.
Copy. And they come to this Eclipse and say file.
Okay.
New.
Yes.
New. Other.
Okay.
Under that web service client.
Okay.
And next. So paste the definition. Server runtime. Access to. So say next.
Again, I'm getting the same error.
Same error. Yeah.
I have used 1.64 even.
So by generating the code only, visual generation code only has got some problem actually.
Okay.
So you have tried multiple times, right? Same thing?
Yeah.
You have sent this error message to me, no?
Yeah, already sent it.
Okay, okay, I'll check it because this is the first time I'm seeing this error. Let me check it, what is the problem. And okay. If you're not getting, let me make you do from the beginning. Let me see how you are doing. Okay?
Okay.
So tomorrow if you get some time, we'll do that.
Okay then. Thank you.
For now, you can skip on this and you can work on REST web services.
Yeah, REST web services is working. That's not a problem. Yeah. Okay.
So that's about for today. And anyone, any other questions?
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah. Anyone, any other questions? Other people?
No. No.
Right. So that's about today. And tomorrow we'll start up with helping. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Recap your JDBC concepts once before you join tomorrow. Okay? Yeah. Thank you all. Okay.